Welcome to the tutorial classes. Today's topic for the discussion is ion selective electrode. Let's see how the question will be asked. These are the questions taken from the previous semester question papers. It can be asked like, what are ion selective electrodes? Explain the construction and working of a glass electrode. Or define ion selective electrode. Describe the construction and working of a glass electrode. So, same thing can also be asked as, what are ion selective electrodes? Discuss the construction and working of a glass electrode. So let's see the definition first. The split up of the marks goes like this. The first part of the question, that is definition of ion selective electrode, will fetch you the 2 marks. The rest of the marks, that is 4 marks, will be for the construction and derivation. That is, finally we should arrive at the electrode potential for the glass electrode. That will give you another 4 marks. Let's see the definition. The definition goes like this. Ion selective electrode is one which selectively responds to a specific ion in a mixture, and the potential delta at the electrode is a function of concentration of that ion in a solution. What is the meaning of this means? So now the glass membrane is called as the electrode, ion selective electrode. This is called as a ion selective electrode, and this bulb is filled with 0.1 molar HCl, and outside the bulb there is another solution, and it will be a mixture of different ions. Like it can have the H plus ions, or it can have the other ions like Cl minus, Ca2 plus, etc. The other minus probably like Ca2 plus is present, Na plus is present, or Cl minus is present, OH minus. That means a mixture of ions will be there in the bulb. Not in the bulb, it is outside the bulb. Let me undo this and show it again. Only outside the bulb I have to show the lines. I will assume this as Ca2 plus ions are present outside the bulb. Ca2 plus ions, Na plus, other ions like Cl minus, and one more ion like OH. Different types of ions are present in a solution, but our membrane, that is a glass bulb, will have a special attraction or affinity towards only the H plus. This glass membrane will have the attraction towards the H plus, even though a n number of other ions are available here. And at the surface of the bulb, the potential will be keep on changing only with respect to the one which shows the affinity. This type of electrodes only called as ion selective electrode. Now I will read the definition, hope you will understand. Ion selective electrode is a one which selectively responds to. Ion selective electrode is a one which selectively responds to a specific ion in a mixture, and the potential is developed at the electrode is a function of the concentration of that particular ion. That means any change in the concentration of this ion changes the potential at the membrane. This type of electrodes are called as ion selective electrode. This is the meaning. For writing the answer, we need to write only this much. So moving on to the construction, how it is constructed. So let's see, what is this ion selective electrode? The best example for the ion selective electrode is a glass electrode. Actually, the potential of this mainly depends upon the pH of the medium. Now, how it is constructed means, look at this diagram, very, very simple one. actually it consists of a thin walled glass membrane, and this portion, you please look at the laser movement, this portion of the bulb is made up of a special type of glass consisting of 72% of SiO2, 22% of Na2O and 6% of CaO. It's a mixture. What is the speciality about it means it's having low melting point and relatively high electrical conductivity. That is the reason this bulb is made up of the special type of glass. Now, the bulb is filled with this inner wall. Inside the bulb, HCl of known concentration is taken. That is 0.1 molar HCl is taken. Along with that, a silver fluoride electrode is immersed into it, and this is called as internal reference electrode. This whole setup is called as a glass electrode. Explain the construction of a glass electrode means your answer goes like this. It consists of a thin walled glass bulb. The bulb is made up of a special type of glass consisting of 72% of SiO2 and 22% of Na2O and 6% of CaO. The reason behind is it has a low melting point and high electrical conductivity. This bulb area is filled with 0.1 molar HCl, and an internal reference electrode, silver chloride, is immersed into it. It is called as the glass electrode. Construction is only this much. Now moving on to the working part. For the working part, we should imagine the glass bulb is placed in another beaker containing HCl solution. So the one which is present inside the bulb, the concentration of that is already labeled as C2. The HCl solution which is kept outside the big bulb, it is taken as C1 concentration. Now let's see. One more point you should remember. The strength of the HCl which is kept outside, always consider it as higher concentration. The one which is present inside the bulb is considered as a lower concentration. Now, a boundary potential will be developed at the junction. How it is, let me explain. See, in the beaker, you have the H plus ions. Let me write it as H plus ions present in the beaker. And from the construction, we understood that this bulb is made up of a special type of glass, in which there is 22% of sodium oxide is present, and the rest I will simply write it as Gl-. And you have to imagine this glass as a semi-permeable membrane. There is a possibility of exchange of the ions taking place here. What happens? This H plus ions which are present in the solution of C1 concentration, that means outside the beaker, and this Na plus ions are present in the membrane. So now, once it is immersed, there is an exchange of the H plus with the Na plus taking place. Same thing, I'll put it as Na plus dissolves into the solution and H plus take the place of the Na plus. So due to which, what happens is the concentration or the strength of the HCl outside the beaker, outside the bulb, outside the membrane will be changing. So according to this equation, you can imagine there is an exchange of H plus ions with the membrane. This H plus are exchanging with the Na plus of the membrane. Due to that, the concentration of the HCl outside the bulb also changes, and it will create a potential called as E1. Outside the bulb, the potential is E1, and inner wall of the bulb, the potential is denoted by the E2. Why? Because the strength of HCl taken outside is C1 and it is greater than the C2. Now let us apply the Nernst equation for a cell. E cell is nothing but a boundary potential. How the boundary potential is arising? Due to the exchange of H plus ions with the Na plus of the membrane. Because of this, there will be one particular potential at the outer wall of the membrane and there is one particular potential at the inner wall of the membrane, that is called as a boundary potential. So also we know, according to the concentration cell, the one with the higher concentration is taken as a cathode, the one with the lower concentration is taken as a anode. So now when you substitute the values for E1 and E2, you will come to know, when you apply the Nernst equation for the single electrode of E1 and E2, it takes the form 0.0591 log C1 minus 0.0591 C2. One more point you should remember here, C2 is nothing but the HCl which is inside the bulk, that will not alter, it remains the same. This is a constant. That is why this equation changes too. Eb is equal to, see this whole thing along with the negative sign, we have taken it as a constant K. Why? Because H plus concentration inside the bulb, it is same, it won't change. That is why this equation changes to K plus 0.0591 C1. That means the boundary potential is changing with respect to the strength of the solution outside the beaker. This is only the boundary potential. But we need to derive an expression for the glass electrode itself, and it is a sum of three potentials. What are those potentials? Before going for the glass electrode potential, so this H plus, that C1, can be written in the form of a H plus. We know the definition, pH is equal to minus log H plus. Based on that, this equation I can write it as Eb is equal to K minus 0.0591 pH. Why here minus? Because plus log of H plus is equal to minus pH. That is why there is a minus sign here. Now, the glass electrode potential has three components. One is called as a boundary potential, that already we have derived here. We got an expression for the boundary potential. So the second is internal reference electrode potential. Potential of internal reference electrode, that is a fixed one. Along with that, there is one more third potential, that is called as asymmetric potential. What is this asymmetric potential? It arises because of the curvature of the glass bulb, meaning same number of H plus might not be exchanged all over the surface of the bulb. That will create the third type of the potential called as a asymmetric potential. But for a given bulb, this asymmetric potential remains constant. This value is constant, this value is constant, only this is the variable. So the equation is something like this. Eg is equal to Eb plus electrode potential due to internal reference electrode, electrode potential due to asymmetric effect. These two are constants. Since these two are constants, only variable is this. Let's see that. So K is a constant, this is a constant, and this is a constant. Instead of writing these many constants, let's write only one constant, that is Eg naught. What is the value of Eg naught? This is K plus E of internal reference electrode and E of asymmetric effect. This is called as glass electrode potential. So if they are asking you a question, define ion selective electrode and explain the construction and working of ion selective electrode, up to here is your answer. Hope you understood this question. Continuation of the same, one more question can be asked. Under glass electrode, there are two possible questions. Out of the two, one will be asked. Next question, let me see. Illustrate how a glass electrode is used to determine the pH of a solution. For that, the principle is something like this. You are familiar with the glass electrode? Now the glass electrode must be coupled with. Already we have studied the glass electrode. that is coupled with another reference electrode like calomel electrode. So this is the reference electrode, a calomel electrode, and this is the glass electrode. Left hand side is a glass electrode, right hand side I have placed the calomel electrode. So to determine the pH of a given solution, a glass electrode must be coupled with another reference electrode called as calomel electrode. Then the cell representation for this is, the cell representation is according to the IUPAC concept, left hand side is the anode. We have to write the anode, and right hand side we have to write the cathode. But here I made a little bit difference. Actually, you have to reverse these electrodes. When you reverse this electrode, this equation will be appropriate. So left hand side, what I have is, what I am going to take is, I will take anode as a calomel electrode and cathode as a glass electrode. I'll repeat again, students don't get confused. Here diagram, in the diagram you can reverse, you can reverse the electrodes. Here I'm taking, see, this is platinum Hg bar Hg2, this is called as a calomel electrode. This should be placed on the left hand side. In the diagram you have to alter the diagram. And this one is a glass electrode, it should be placed on the right hand side. You have to alter the diagram here. Why? Because this equation, what I have shown here is calomel, I have taken it as an anode, and glass I have taken it as a cathode. That's why you have to exchange this. So depending on the strength of the solution, calomel can act either as an anode or as a cathode. It's a, both the ways it can act, that we have studied in a previous class. Now, by assuming the calomel as an anode and glass as a cathode, so we can write the Nernst equation for a cell. The cell is E cell is equal to E cathode minus E anode. What is my cathode? Cathode is a glass electrode. I know the expression for the glass electrode as Eg0 minus 0.0591 pH. And what is a reference electrode potential? Electrode potential of calomel electrode. Now this equation you have to rearrange to get an expression for the pH. When you do that simplification, you will get pH is equal to Eg0 minus E of SCE minus E cell whole divided by 0.0591. That means in the pH meter, you are going here, it's not voltmeter, you need to take the pH meter. In the pH meter, it shows some pH value. So like that, it is possible to determine the pH of the solution. These are the very important questions. Either of the two can be asked in the exam, students. Thank you.